morning and welcome to Seeking God Daily. Today is a blessed day and a beautiful day because we are aware that God is around us. He lives in us if we're a Christian, and we can seek Him no matter where we're at, what time of the day, and all over the world. He sees everything that's going on. Today, I have a question for all of you. What are you seeking God for? What are you running away from? And how long have you sought for God's answer? God, in His time, is perfect in all things. Sometimes we try to rush things because of the world that we live in. Everything has speeded up. Everything is rushed. Give it to me now. I can't wait any longer. Go about your business and do whatever you need to do and do it quickly, because we just feel like it has to be done in a second instead of maybe sitting quietly and waiting on what God is doing. We look outside and we can see traffic rushing up and down the road. They're in such a hurry they can't even slow down to let a pedestrian cross the road, but what they don't try to run over top of them. We hear phone calls going off all the time. This and that is happening all around the world. And sometimes it's best just to turn your phone off and sit quietly. How long do you sit with the Lord, and what do you allow His Spirit to speak to you? Have you really thought about what God wants to say to you every morning? Every day, every second, maybe? Sometimes in a rushed world, we have so much noise going on that we don't take time to listen to the silence. When silence is there, we don't know what to do with ourselves. We think, oh, what's going on? There's no noise. What's happened? Has everybody left? Well, maybe they have. Maybe some are asleep. Maybe some are at work. Maybe something else is going on in their minds. But where are you in the silence? What are you longing for? What do you want God to say to you? These are the questions I want to ask everyone who comes to hear this message today. What can I do to be patient and quietly waiting for the Lord to speak to me so that I can be receptive when His voice speaks to me? I want you to think about that. I want you to dwell upon God's Word and what He has promised us and what He has given us, because sometimes we have to quietly sit to receive. Precious Holy Father, we come and in quietness we lift up our heart, our thoughts, our body, and in the calmness of Your presence, we can sit and receive the Word that You have for us today. Sometimes we are so rushed about that we don't even think of what You might have for us today, that Your plan is bigger than our plans, that Your love is more vast than our love, that Your blessings can overflow in us if we would just allow time to sit and meditate and quietly think upon You. Calmness comes to the heart that is peacefully resting in Your love, in Your joy, in Your peace. Today, my Lord, I ask that You touch every heart that is seeming to have no answers with an answer from Your touch, and say so peacefully to them, I am here, child. Just wait. Wait for my answer. In my timing, I can give it to you, and it will be perfect. We long for you, Lord, in the quietness, the stillness of the morning, and early of the day we could get up and rise up to meet you and gladly receive all things that you have planned for us. You are holy and mighty, glorious and beautiful. And sometimes, Lord, you just want us to be quiet in your presence and think about your word and how you come to us to speak to us about your thoughts, your heart's desires. We are so caught up on the I word. I need it now. I am the only one that is in this room. Pay attention to me. The selfishness of self is so prevalent in the world today. But we need to be quiet and let you, the great I am, speak to the person inside of us, our spirit, given to us from you, that we may know how to have a servant's heart, ears of compassion to hear, and eyes of spiritual sight to see, and receive with gladness the joy of your salvation and your word that you implant deep in our hearts, that we may always walk with you constantly, daily, throughout every second of the day, rejoicing that we are your child. You answer prayers and miracles happen. Babies are being born. It's a miracle. Healing is being done in hospitals. That's a miracle. Blessings flowing down from your hand. It's a miracle. The spirit of your sweet counsel comes in and speaks to us. That's a miracle, because we are but dust and you created us, every one of us, and you know everything about us and how great and glorious you are. Today, Lord, I pray that they can come and be quiet in your presence, that they would listen with intent hearing and ask of you, Lord, what shall I do to receive of you counsel from your sweet spirit, and help me go about this day to be a blessing to another. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray and ask it all. Amen. Now, let's look to the word and see what it says about quiet. When he giveth quietness, who can make trouble? And when he hideth his face, who then can behold him? Whether it be done against a nation or against a man only. And this was Job 34:29 in the King James Bible. And Psalms 131:2 says, surely I have behaved and quieted myself as a child that is weaned of his mother, my soul even as a weaned child. We can sit. Wean ourselves from television, telephones, cars, buses, whatever, the noise that's going on around us. Wean it all out of your mind and sit quietly and listen to what the Lord is saying. There may be a blessing that you have missed out on so many times because of the noise of the world that tries to come in and make confusion. In Proverbs 133, but whosoever hearkeneth unto me shall dwell safely and shall be quiet from fear of evil. We don't have to have fear of evil. Never in a lifetime do we have to have fear of evil. We can walk quietly with the Lord and be blessed in the peace of his presence. In Isaiah 32:17, and the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness quietness, and assurance forever. Lamentations 3:26, it is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. Hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. If you're in trouble, being distressed on every hand, and you need an answer, hope and just sit quietly and wait for the Lord to show up. All you have to do is say a prayer from your heart and be sincere and believe, and you shall receive it in the full faith that God has given you, even from a child, because we develop even greater faith as we trust and believe in the Lord to answer us. Mark 4:39, and he arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. John 11:20, then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him, but Mary sat still in the house. Sit still in the house. We can be still before the Lord and receive answers that we have been asking about. But we have to get rid of the noise of the distractions, the phones, the televisions, the movies, whatever, the games. Sometimes it's better to just sit still and receive than to be noisy and miss out. May God bless you today with the quietness of his peace upon your soul, blessings of his love overflowing, and joy to rejoice you in a depth like you've never known before. Have a beautiful, blessed day. If you enjoyed this video, click like. If you haven't subscribed and you would like to, please do. And if you want, leave me a comment. Thank you so much, and have a beautiful day.